85% of us finding what our calling is looking within ourselves. And so I think that there are so many people out there that are hurting. You know, we've talked about it. So many people have lost their jobs, or they've been in situations that they've been happy for a long time but just don't know how to move forward. They feel stuck, if you will. And I think sometimes they just need somebody else to help them think differently, to kind of change their paradigm. And if you've never had somebody help you do that, it's very hard to do it on your own. My mom was bipolar and also schizophrenic. So I had to grow up at a very young age. There were days that I didn't know whether I was going to be hugged or slapped, or if I was going to be moving from one state to the next. So really there was a lot of uncertainty. When I was a senior in high school, that was the time when my mom's illness was just really bad, and I couldn't get her any help. When I was 20 years old, it was 1989, my professor came into the class. I was going to the University of South Alabama, and my teacher said, "The wall has fallen in Berlin, and we are going to teach English as a second language." Here's the thing, I had no money. I had a roommate, so I had responsibility and bills, and I had a job. So I went to the meeting, and I just wanted to go. And my mom was homeless at this time, and I just really felt like I needed to get away, and I was praying about it, and I just knew I wanted to go. And I found out that I could write letters for sponsorship. So in 3 weeks, I had raised the money. My job, they came in and said, "We will not only give you some money to help you go, but we'll keep your job when you come back." And my roommate came up to me, I didn't ask her, said, "I really know you need to do this. I really feel like this is something you need to do, and I'll take care of your rent for the 4 months while you're gone." At that period of time when I was gone, my mother got committed. So basically, I was out of a country. I couldn't be called. I couldn't be contacted. My mother was actually picked up by the authorities and started to get the help that she so desperately wouldn't get on her own. And I really believe that growing up the way that I did, struggling, growing up, getting free lunch, you know, being a poor person, right? Being a poor person, I really had to find a way to believe in myself. I really had to find a way to say, you know, because my life is like this, it doesn't have to be. So I started a plan. I decided I was going to go to school and get an education. If I had listened to my mother tell me that I wasn't worth it, and that, you know, why am I raising money for poor people because I'm poor, and, you know, why does she have to do this again, and, you know, you're indigent, and all these, if I kept listening to those messages, would I not believe that I never had any opportunities? But see, when I went to Czechoslovakia and I saw how happy those people were, and how excited they were to start all over in a democracy where they had no idea what was going to happen, I knew that I could do anything that I wanted to. Forget what everybody else has told you you are. Your past doesn't equal your future, and you can make a decision today. It's not about the job you have, but it's about the person that you are.